What's up, guys? Tony Rex up in here once again with the updated build for the now called Sunder Gank build. Previously, in my previous video, I called it the Summer Gank build, but went through some changes, guys, because let's be realistic. I mean, soon, you know, at least over here, freaking Wisconsin is gonna start snowing, and you know, you can't go through autumn and winter and then spring, what, calling the build the Summer Gank? Like, it doesn't flow, you know what I mean? So I was like, well, why call it Summer Gank? Might as well call it the Sunder Gank build, and it involves the Sunder Flame set, so it just flows a little bit better, and it goes hand in hand with the name, right, and the build. So let's go right into it, guys. For more in-depth, you know, as far as the CP, the most of the skills, you can see my previous video. You know, there's been some tweaks for this build, especially for the event, the Imperial Sewers, or Imperial City, I'm sorry, Sewers and the Districts events going on right now. At the time, it started last Thursday. It's Saturday right now, so we're like 2-3 days into the event. So for the IC event and for Imperial Sewers and ganking in general in this area, I made a couple of tweaks. So I'll show you what it's about. I'll go quickly through it and mostly highlight the actual changes and tweaks, not the actual build, because again, you can go back into that video, the previous video, for more information on that. So let's go quickly into it. Now, first off, of course, Wood Elf, Stamina Nightblade. It's a glass cannon ganking build, not 1vx. Not dual builds, nothing to prove here, nothing like that, guys. So if it's not your playstyle, if it's not something that you want to try or like doing, like ganking, then you know, I wouldn't, you know, of course, I tell you myself. I mean, I don't care if you watch this video or not. I'm not looking to be like a YouTuber, nothing like that. Like you know, so it's okay. You can just, you know, I would even tell you, go forward and look, you know, for another YouTuber, another person out there that might, you know, have a video that suits your style. But if it's a gank, glass cannon, stamina, and nightblade that you're looking for, you know, basically one-shot people or 2-3 hits tops, get in and out, then this might work for you, especially now in the Imperial Sewers event. So these are the stats. First off, Wood Elf. These are the stats fully unbuffed. We'll see what happens when fully buffed. Weapon damage, close to 3,500, stamina recovery basically 1,800, maximum stamina 34k, almost 35k. Of course, vampirism stage 4, because of mobility, and I'll explain that in just a second. Now let's go quickly into the build, guys, and the changes. I'm still running. I did gold out my weapons, by the way. post as to the last video, I didn't have gold weapons, and some traits were wrong. I needed to transmute some things. Everything was purple, but now, you know, at least the weapons are yellow, which is the main thing. Sunder Flame, 5-piece, maximum stam, weapon damage, weapon critical, and the 5th bonus. I explained last time what it does. That's why I like it. Now on the bow, I switched from Master Bow 2, and I did gold out my Sunder Flame bow. If you don't have the Master Bow, you can put always Sunder Flame. It works. It depends on the scenario and what I want to do. But, and then of course, Sunder Flame two-handed and the bow, if you don't have, again, the Master Bow, and then 3 pieces on the body. Now on the remaining, the 3-piece Drooly, all weapon damage, Spriggan, chest infuse, everything divines, by the way, all mediums, one light, but Spriggan, 2-piece on the body. Now, why Spriggan? Good old Spriggan. I went back to this because maximum stamina, 3rd bonus maximum stamina, weapon damage, and then the 5th bonus, insane physical penetration when it stacks up with the ulti from the two-handed. We did switch up from Incap to Berserker. I'll explain why. It just goes through people like butter. I mean, 60-70% of people will get one-shotted. Unless they're a sorcerer, max orc, stacking shields, or a tank, then... And, you know, be wise about that, guys. This is a Varstones, double Varstones event in Imperial City. You know, when ganking, let's make a quick stop here before I go into the Head and Shoulders, you know, that was just released, Balor in the Wolf Hunter Pack DLC just recently. When ganking, and this is just my opinion, you know, a lot of people will argue, you know, like, oh, ganking, it sucks, you know, and go against that, send you hate mail, why you ganking, you're garbage, blah, 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 and they always want to, like, they got that dual mentality. That's fine, I do have my dueling builds for that. I have my 1vx builds, you know, but what I most enjoy ever since the game came out, as far as, like, you know, PvP content, veteran rank days, since Midnight release, I mean, when I hit level 10, on midnight release when ESO came out on PS4, I was already in Cyrodiil and trying to gank people. So it's just what I love. It's just a play style. There's an art to it. There's a way of doing it. You know, most people think it's just I go from hidden and I'm going to gank you and hit ulti and then run away. It's not that easy. That's what most people, the misconception that they get. It's really an art. There's a way of doing it. You know, for me, my opinion, I always said a good gank and a proper gank is where you, you know, are able to gank somebody and then run away and escape, you know, successfully, and then hit a sigil retreat or go to another district, hit the sewers, whatever, go to your base. So it doesn't make sense if I'm going to try, you know, to gank. Most people think, oh, I'm going to gank this person. Then, you know, they gank that person, and then they turn around 180, and there's like two people, three people from the opposing team about ready to back up that person. They're coming towards you and kill you, or a Zerg. So come on now, then you lose the same barstone that you just literally got a second ago. That's not a successful gank. In most videos, in videos that you will see that, you know, they'll show you the gank, but then they won't show you what happens right after. I'm going to be honest myself. I mean, it's really like a 70% to 30% as far as my ratio. Some people might be 50-50. Some people might be 90 and 10. I don't know. Maybe you're just that damn good. Props to you. I feel like I'm more like 70-30, so I have a high level success. I'm not immortal. I do get caught, you know, sometimes people, who is this guy shooting at? Oh my goodness, calm down, buddy. I'm trying to do a build here. Update, droopy. But anyways, you know, it depends, because you know, the rage on how opportunistic you are, how wise you are on ganking. If I see somebody that's obviously fully buffing themselves, they look like a tank, or it's a shield, a stacking sorcerer, they just pop two shields, or you know, come on guys, you gotta be more wiser than that. You're gonna get ganked yourself. You might not be as successful. So yeah, there is some type of strategy and art to ganking. But anyways, let's go back into the build. So if this fits your playstyle, it should work out. It's working out great for me. There will be some highlights shown after the build, so you can see how nasty this thing can get, this build. So now, head and shoulders, big change here. From Mafala in Upland Cyrodiil, opposed to that, I'm using now Balrog. Balrog just came out. I think you can get it at March of Sacrifice, I believe I did it. Ran a couple of times, got the medium head, the helmet, the mask, so I transmuted to Divines. Shoulders, light is the only piece, everything else medium. Now, first bonus, weapon damage and spell damage. Second bonus, when you use an ulti ability, you gain weapon and spell damage for 10 seconds equal to twice the amount of the total ulti consumed. That's why I'm running Berserker, guys, and not Incap. So, let's go talking about Incap to the skills. Now, in the two-handed bar, the DPS main bar for me, we got Executioner, Shadow Disguise. Again, I'm going to go quickly. You can see the previous video for more in-depth. I'm just going to highlight more in the actual changes or tweaks that I made. Concealed Weapon for mobility. Remember, we're Vampire, Stage 4. Camouflage Hunter. Now, be careful, guys, when ganking with this crap. I don't know if Cinemax intended it to be this way, but after the update, now you pop in Camouflage Hunter from freaking hidden, completely sneaking from hidden, and now it exposes you for a full second or two. And then this little red eye comes out, which means basically, you know, for 5 seconds you can, you know, detect other enemies, or put the little, you know, anti-detect little ball or orb on them so they cannot go hidden. But it's taking you out of hidden, which it did not used to do. So just be careful using it. It still works. It just gets you out of hidden for a second when you pop it now. So Relentless Focus. And then ulti, we went from Incap to Berserker Rage. Why? Because it's a vicious blow, indeed, dealing almost 18k physical damage, and ignores the target resistance and grants you that back to you equal to the amount ignored for 8 seconds. That's just nasty, stacking up with Sprig, and it's so much penetration. You go through people like butter, I'm telling you guys, it's just ridiculous. Unless they're a tank or, again, shield stacking sorcerer who's fully buffed. And you might not be wanting to gank that person if they're fully buffed already. Doesn't make sense. This is not 1vx or dueling build. So your job to be successful is gank in and out, get the bar stones, get out. And then let's go to the bow bar. Leeching Strikes, Shuffle, Resolving Vigor, Poison Injection, Fear, or Mass Hysteria, and then of course Dawnbreaker Smite. And if you find yourself in a scenario or a Zerg and you do have that ulti charge up and you have to switch, throw that, stun them, and then hit your retreat, Shadow Disguise. No shaming that, guys. Now let's go into the CP again. I'm gonna go very quickly because just highlighting them, because in the previous video you can see the actual allocation. I have not changed anything, guys. It's basically literally the same. There were 10 more. There's nothing here, by the way, in the Apprentice, so I'm just gonna keep going. There were 10 more CP per color, blue, red, and green, right, that we're adding the Wolf Hunter. And you'll see you can make the math where I put him, but it's just up to your, you know, your taste, your playstyle. So those are the CP. Now, let's go into the stats and then go into the highlights, and we're done with this video, basically. So I'm standing at... There you go, the stats, right? So let's pop the... Let's fully buff. This is what I'm running, by the way. Essence of Speed before we do this. I love it. There's a reason why I don't have Rally, guys. Essence of Speed. Major Expedition. That's why I don't use also, by the way, the Sigic skill line acceleration skill. I just feel it drains too much magicka, and then I don't have enough for my Shadow Disguise, which I need, and my possible Fear if I need it. So it's just too many magicka skills for a stamina build on that build, you know, to have another one on top, you know what I mean? So I just feel comfortable, it's my playstyle. I'm not using, because a couple of buddies have told me, try that skill, the Sigic, blah, blah, blah. I don't feel I need it for this particular build. Why? Essence of Speed gives me that movement speed with the passive in Alchemy, right? At 47, I go up to 47.6 seconds. I get my speed, my brutality, therefore no rally needed from the same pot, and of course my stamina recovery and major endurance, blah, blah, blah. Also, I'm using Lava Foot, guys. A little bit risky. Not a lot of health on this build, but again, you're a glass cannon build, and Lava Foot is just too nasty. Too much max stamina, stamina recovery, so you never find yourself without stamina recovery, to be honest with you. So let's fully buff ourselves and show you the stats once fully buffed. I don't know why I shot bigger, but anyways. Okay, weapon damage, almost 4,400. Stamina recovery, 2,000. And then, you know, the crit stays almost close to 50. But now I will say this. When you hit that glyph from weapon damage, if you do from the bow bar, you find that yourself in that scenario and hit ulti with Balor, I looked at it and I think I went up to 5,100 weapon damage. So it gets very, very extremely nasty in that particular scenario. But realistically, because I'm running, guys, the poison damage, it's near Haneda trait, but on my wall maul, which I find myself most of the time because I'm ganking, not on my bow bar, but on my two-handed bar, and the poison damage glyphs, you know, I don't hit that weapon damage glyph. You can always put this infused if you feel like it and put the weapon damage up front. I bet you will go up to 5,100, and I just might try it myself, so we'll see. But the numbers are still nice either way, and you will see in the highlights how successful this is, you know, and how it fits, you know, my playstyle for ganking. So, hope you enjoyed it, guys, and I will see you around in the Imperial Sewers event. If you are in the PS4 server, just be careful because, you know, I might just gank you, so be careful out there, guys. All right, see you around, people.